I am gonna read the storybook called Goldilocks and the Three Bears. Let's get started. Once upon a time, there was a little girl called Goldilocks. She had lovely golden hair and looked as good as gold. But Goldilocks wasn't good. She was naughty. She liked to do something naughty every day. If you don't stop being naughty, said her mother, your hair will turn blue.
Yay!
I don't believe you, said Goldilocks, and put salt in the sugar pot.
Yay!
If you carry on like this, said her father, you'll grow words on your nose. I don't believe you, said Goldilocks.
Yes.
And give her little brother a haircut. Now, thought Goldilocks, what shall I do next? Then she remembered the woods. Her mother always said, don't go into the woods. They are full of bears. That made Goldilocks want to go there even more. Goldilocks waited until no one was watching and crept out through the back door. This is fun, thought Goldilocks. As she skipped down the path, Goldilocks skipped around the corner and saw a pretty little cottage. Goldilocks knocked on the door. There was no answer, but there was a delicious smell coming from inside. Mum, said Lady Goldilocks, walked in. She followed the smell and saw three bowls of porridge on the table. I am so hungry. I'm sure no one would notice if I had a tiny taste. First, Goldilocks tried the great big bowl. Yuck, too cold. Next, she tried the middle-sized bowl. Oh, too hot. Last of all, Goldilocks tried the porridge in the tiny bowl. Mom, just right. She ate it all up. Feeling full, Goldilocks looked for somewhere to sit. First, she tried the great big chair. Too hot, said Goldilocks. Next, she tried the middle-sized chair. Too soft. Last of all, Goldilocks tried the tiny chair. It's just that, thought Goldilocks, until crack, the chair broke it. Oops, giggled Goldilocks. I'll just lie down instead. Goldilocks climbed the stairs into the bedroom. Oh, three beds to choose from. So she tried the first bed, too hard. She tried the second bed, too soft. She tried the third bed. Just right, said Goldilocks. In no time at all, Goldilocks was fast asleep. It's just let a large heavy paw pushed at the front door. There was a great big father bear, a middle-sized mother bear, and a cuddly little baby bear. Father Bear went straight to the table. He was hungry. He looked at his porridge bowl and let out a great big growl. Who's been eating my porridge? He said in his great gruff voice. Who's been eating my porridge? Said Mother Bear in her middle-sized voice. Who's been eating my porridge? Squeaked little baby bear in his tiny voice. Father Bear looked around the room. Who's been sitting in my chair? He growled in his great rough voice.
who's been sitting in my chair? Asked Mother Bear in her middle-sized voice. Who's been sitting in my chair? Squeak, Baby Bear, they've broken it. Then the three bears heard a loud snore from outside. They climbed the stairs. Who's been sleeping in my bed? Growled Father Bear in his great gruff voice. Who's been sleeping in my bed? Said Mother Bear in her middle-sized voice. Who's been sleeping in my bed? Squeaked Baby Bear in his tiny voice. She's still here. Baby Bear began to cry. He cried so loudly. Goldilocks woke up. She looked at the three bears, opened her mouth and screamed. Goldilocks ran out of the house. She ran home as fast as she could go. I'll never be naughty again. The end.